When it comes to repair, the Pixel 9 Pro Fold is not like other foldable smartphones. It's not even like the Pixel 9 Pro XL we just tore down. The Pixel 9 Pro Fold is the most exciting foldable we've seen on the iFixit teardown table. Let's take a look at why that is. On day one, Google made repair manuals and spare parts for the Pixel 9 Pro Fold available to consumers. That's a huge positive, because a repairable smartphone without spare parts is like a piñata without sweets. It's just gonna disappoint. A quick disclaimer before we start the teardown, we work with Google to provide spare parts through our store, but our teardowns are performed independent of any input from Google. Now, if you're thinking about upgrading your old Pixel device to one of these newer devices, hold off, we have a proposition for you. We've got a ton of screen and battery fix kits for Pixel phones that have all the parts and tools you'll need to get your old phone running like new again, and step-by-step guides that walk you through the entire process of repairing your device. Check out the links in the description for more info. The Pixel 9 Pro Fold is no empty piñata. Thanks to our friends at Lumafield, we're able to see the intricate details of this foldable before diving into the teardown proper. You too can get your hands on an interactive version of this scan and check out anything from the cameras to the hinge mechanism. Just head on over to our blog post on ifixit.com. On to the teardown. Since we have a repair guide for this device, we might as well follow it. To get things started, I'm going to remove the back cover without using any heat. To my surprise, it works. It took a bit more prying than I'd like, but you can't argue with the results. It takes only a few moments to cut through the adhesive, and lifting the back cover reveals a single press connector secured by a Torx screw. Swiftly dispatching that connector lets me remove the rear cover entirely. Here's another repairability win right here. The outside screen can also be removed without using any heat. In fact, this screen comes away even more easily than the rear cover. Another Torx screw holds a press connector in place, and popping that connector lets me remove the exterior panel and reveal the interior of both sides of this foldable phone. Starting on my right-hand side, I have two screws to remove, and that lets me remove one of the interconnect cables running across the battery. Another few screws towards the bottom of the phone frees up two more press connectors, and that now lets me clear the battery of both interconnect cables. It looks like the daughter board housing the SIM reader is now free, so I'm going to eject the SIM tray and remove the board entirely. Moving over to the opposite side, I'm undoing all the screws and brackets I can find, stopping for a moment to disconnect the battery connector, and from there moving on to disconnect the remaining brackets, antennas, and cables. There's a few to be sure, but eventually I'm able to remove the main board, camera assembly, and 5G antenna all in one go. With the main board out the way, I can remove the lower speaker and the modular and replaceable USB-C port. USB-C ports suffer a lot of mechanical wear, so being able to remove this part is a big repairability win. But for all these positives, the Pixel 9 Pro Fold still uses the same sucky battery pull tabs I found in the Pixel 9 Pro XL. This time, I followed the manual and applied 70 degrees centigrade heat for 5 minutes. It did diddly squat, and I ended up using a suction cup and alcohol to get it out. The same goes for the big battery. Come on, Google, you've come so far. Why use these lackluster pull tabs? Again, a few drops of isopropyl alcohol loosens the adhesive enough to suction the last battery out of the case. The smaller battery is rated for 4.68 watt-hours, and the larger battery is rated for 13.4 watt-hours, giving the device a combined 18.08 watt-hours to draw from. At this point, I've removed all the critical components in this device, and all that's left is the foldable OLED. Any inner screen repair would involve buying the housing and inner screen as a single module, and replacing all these components inside the new housing. But that's not going to stop us. For the sake of the teardown, we're going to continue and remove that inner screen. Just like all other foldables, the process is pretty destructive when performed by a layman. I've done this a half dozen times now, and each time the screen gets ruined in the process. This is simply not a serviceable component for us mere mortals. But since Google is committed to offering the replacement part at launch, it softens the blow a bit. So what makes the Pixel 9 Pro Fold the most exciting foldable we've seen? Well, it all comes down to Google providing repair guides and replacement parts at launch. While it's something more and more companies are looking at doing, it's still pretty rare to find this level of commitment to repair from a major manufacturer. Combine parts and guides with a device that's easy to open and has modular parts, and you've got a phone with very little to complain about.